going on, guys? On today's video, I'm going to be talking about the same thing basically everybody in the photography world has been talking about lately. Canon's new cameras, the R6 and the R5. On today's video, I'm going to be talking about the difference between the two cameras, and more specifically, why I will not be getting the Canon R5. But before I do that, I want to let you guys know that I'm starting some online photography courses, workshops, seminars, and photo critiques at the end of this month. There's a blog post that I've written explaining how it's all going to work and how you can get involved. So in the description to this video, there's a link over to my blog and it'll explain how those are going to go down. It's mostly going to be Zoom workshops. Now, the R5 and the R6. Honestly, game changers. And I don't say, I do say that a lot. I say that things are game changers way too much when they're actually not. These cameras are game changers. This is not the R6. This is Jody's RP, which is also being used to film this video. Well, my version of it. And this is my R. My current setup is the R is my stills camera and the RP is my video camera. For months and months and months, I was 100% sure that I was going to be getting the Canon R5 to replace the R. But as time kind of progressed and moved along, I was like, I don't need the R5. But I kind of want to divide today's video. No. Every time. So this video is kind of going to be split into four parts. The first part, I'm going to talk really quick about whether you need to upgrade your camera. The second part, I'm going to do a comparison that's going to be like pretty intensive between the R5 and the R6. And then I'm going to talk about why I'm not going to get the R5 and then about why I am going to get the R6. If you want to jump ahead to either chapter, down in the bottom of the video, YouTube now has chapters and you can skip ahead, which is awesome. So if you don't want to hear me yabbing on like I currently am, you can always just jump ahead to the next part. So do you need to upgrade your camera? I did a video years ago in Georgia with the reasons why you would want to upgrade your camera, why you might need to upgrade your camera. I think there's basically three reasons. The first reason, you broke your camera. Like if I broke my R, I dropped it right now, I think I would have just cause to get the R5. The other reason would be if your current camera is holding you back from doing something. For example, you're shooting a crop sensor camera and you really want to do astrophotography and it's not cutting it, or you're shooting something like the RP and it doesn't have a fast enough frame rate to do wildlife photography. Those are all really good reasons to upgrade. And then the third reason is you're rich and you don't care about money, then upgrade, do whatever you want. I'm not gonna tell you what to do with your rich person money. Now let's get into the R5 versus R6 comparison. I think overall it's good news for consumers because the R6 seems to be great value, and the overlying thesis statement that I'm gonna go through is that the R6 and the R5 have more alike than they have different. But the biggest difference other than the price between the two cameras is how many megapixels there are. The R5 has 45 megapixels and the R6 only has 20, which is on the low end for sure. Lower megapixels isn't necessarily a bad thing. In fact, it has advantages, which we'll get to. The only reason you need a ton of megapixels, in my opinion, is if you're printing massively. If you're shooting a 20 megapixel camera, you can basically print to 20 by 30. And the seagulls are going for it now. If you have a 45 megapixel camera, you can print 40 to 60 or even bigger. Come on, seagulls, chill out. I'm trying to film. But if your photos are mostly for web use, social media, small prints, or even magazine sales, you don't need the big megapixel count. And there is another advantage to the smaller file sizes of the smaller megapixel camera, and that's that it can actually have a bigger buffer. Both the Canon R5 and R6 do 12 frames per second photos. They do 20 frames per second with the electronic viewfinder, which is really fast. But because the R6 has smaller file sizes, you can get up to a buffer of 240 raw images, whereas the R5, it's only 180. I shouldn't say it's only 180, it's 180. That's a lot of photos. Another advantage to the lower megapixel count is actually better ISO capabilities. The R5 has an ISO range of 100 to like 51,000, whereas the R6 has double that. It's from 100 to 1,000 something. And both are expandable to double that on the top end and 50 on the low end. So you actually have a bigger ISO range with the R6 to the R5. Due to the lower megapixel count as well, you have better low light focusing. You can focus on the R6 to -6.5 EF, whereas on the R5 it's -6. Both are still amazing, just slightly better on the R6. Both have basically identical autofocusing capabilities as well. They both have over 5,000 autofocus points. They both have 100% coverage. Although they say the R5 focuses slightly faster than the R6. In fact, the R5 is the fastest focusing camera that Canon makes. And I think actually Canon might claim the fastest anybody makes. Cosmetically, it's where there's a big difference between the two cameras. The R5 has better weather sealing than the R6, although that doesn't really make sense to me, because if it's weather sealed, it's weather sealed. How can one be more sealed than the other? The R5's also a beefier build than the R6, a little bit sturdier. Both cameras have dual card slots, although I think some people will complain it doesn't have three now. The Canon R5 has a CF slot, which is the C-Fast cards, which are needed for the bigger file sizes and video, as we'll get to, and then one SD. The R6 has two SD slots. The R5 also has a top-down menu, which is like this on my Canon R, and the R6 has a dial menu like this one on the RP. Personally, I prefer the dial. That's just personal preference. And then both have articulating LCD touchscreens. The EVF, the electronic viewfinder, on the R5 is better than the R6. It's got a higher resolution, something like 5 million dots versus 3 million dots. For a lot of people, what this actually comes down to, this battle between the R5 and the R6, is video. The R5 is definitely more powerful than the R6 when it comes to that to video. In fact, I think Canon finally just woke up and realized that basically everybody reviewing cameras these days are filmmakers and not photographers, and that people get a little bit obsessed with video specs. They are talking about 4K 60 frames per second video on a photo camera. And Canon's finally jumped into this battle and they've gone like fully in, dropping 8K video on the R5 that's uncropped. And there is a huge advantage to this 8K in that if you shoot 8K video, you get something like a 34 megapixel photo as a screen grab. So if you're shooting video and there's a moment that's perfect, you can always use that as a photo frame. A 30 something megapixel photo. That's incredible. And you can shoot Canon log raw format. The R5 also does 4K 120 frames per second. On the R6, you can only do 4K 60 frames per second. Yes, you can do Canon log raw files as well. In 1080p, you can do 120 frames per second on the R6. So the R5 is definitely more of a beast when it comes to video specs. Now, both cameras actually have in-body stabilization for the first time ever on a Canon mirrorless full frame. And it's said to be incredible. And obviously I haven't used either, but Canon's reporting 8 stops of stabilization on their in-body. That's crazy. So that's the comparison. And as you guys probably can tell by my enthusiasm to the R6, the more I look at the specs of the two, the more I get more excited about the R6 and less excited about the R5. So why won't I be getting the R5? Well, I don't think that there's anything the R5 does that makes me a better photographer. Yeah, it's got a better sensor. Yeah, it probably is better in low light and it's probably got better noise handling. But nothing that it does makes me a better photographer. I don't see myself shooting 8K. I don't really need to do 4K 120 frames per second video. And nothing of the R5 goes, this camera is gonna make you a better photographer than using the R. So I will be sticking with my Canon R as my main stills camera for the foreseeable future. That doesn't mean that I'll never get the R5. I still want it. I'm just not gonna get it now. The R6, on the other hand, I will be getting because it does improve my craft. Right now, I'm shooting the videos for, you know, the vlog and all the travel stuff on the RP. And there's 4 things the RP doesn't have that I wish it had. In-body stabilization. I've stopped using my gimbal. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but I just don't use it anymore. I've been finding it restrictive. So I want in-body stabilization to get me smooth footage. The RP doesn't have that. The R6 does. I want to start doing some videos in 4K, maybe not all of them, but some of them. But I like my 60 frames per second. I like to use slow-mo. This has 4K 30 frames per second, not 60 frames. And also it's cropped. So if I'm vlogging myself, it's way too much of my face. Whereas the R6 has uncropped 4K at 60 frames per second. And of course that uncropped 4K is another thing I wanted, so that's 3. And then 4 is 120 frames per second at 1080p. I'm still gonna be filming most of the vlogs at 1080p rather than 4K, but I really want that like buttery 120 frame per second option. I think that's gonna be amazing. So yeah, I will be getting the Canon R6 at some point. The current world crisis has definitely affected kind of my decision making. Pre-crisis, I think I would have been just totally brazen and brash and been like, I'm just gonna get both cameras. Even if I don't need to upgrade my R, I'm gonna get both because I want them. But now it's kind of made me think a little bit more. I've had to cancel a lot of my work for 2020, and so I kind of just want to like be a little bit more responsible. And the responsible decision, whether I had work or not, would probably be to hold off on getting the R5. So I'm not going to say I'm not going to get the R5 at all at any point in the future. I probably will, just not yet. Whereas the R6, it's going to come. In fact, I'm going into my computer right now and pre-ordering it. The R6 will be used as my vlogging camera, and I'll probably also use it for things like astrophotography at night if that sensor just seems to be a little bit better than the R's is. So that's what's going on. Now, in the comments of this video, I want to know if you guys are getting the R5 or the R6. Let me know. I am going to have another travel photography vlog on Thursday, I believe, from here in Portugal. It should be fun. So I'll see you there. Peace.